Hello everyone, I am Dr. Shami Nagpal, Associate Professor, Dayanand College, Hisar. And today we are going to talk about pronouns, a topic that is very important, not only for the college syllabus, but also for the competitive exams. Pronoun is very important for sentence correction. So dear students, let's get down to discussing what are the mistakes that we end up making while handling pronouns. Now, we all know what pronouns stand for. It is very easy for us. A word that is used in place of a noun. या हम अपनी भाषा में बात करें तो वो शब्द जो संज्ञा के स्थान पर प्रयोग किए जाते हैं उन्हें सर्वनाम कहते हैं. That is what pronoun is. Even after knowing the definition, we end up making a lot of mistakes in our sentences. And the reason is that we do not know what are the types of pronouns. We are not natives. हमारी भाषा नहीं है English. और यही कारण है कि हम pronouns में अक्सर गलतियां कर जाते हैं. So let's get down to knowing about the type of pronouns. First and foremost pronoun that I'm going to talk about today is the personal pronoun. What do we mean by personal pronoun? A personal pronoun is a pronoun that is used for a person. Wait, let me get to the next slide. Here, types of pronouns. And now we come to personal pronouns. So as I said, personal pronoun is a pronoun that is used for a person. Now, if we look at the types of personal pronouns, there can be nominative, accusative, जो हमें सुनने में और पढ़ने में बहुत मुश्किल लगता है. So for your own convenience, what I have done is, I have tried to simplify it. And I have divided personal pronouns into three categories. And the categories are subjective, objective, and possessive. एक एक करके इनके बारे में हम बात कर लेंगे. Now before I come down to explaining subjective and objective, we all know that a sentence in English is a complete sentence if it has a subject, a verb, and an object. So those pronouns, like I take a small example for you all, he likes mangoes. He mera subject ho gaya, like mera verb ho gaya, likes here in this sentence, and mango mera object ho gaya. So till we have these three in a sentence, a sentence cannot be called a complete sentence. Now, a subjective pronoun is a pronoun that is used in place of the subject. So, what could be my subjective pronouns? He, she, I, we, they, and it. Agar aap inko sentence mein laga kar dekho, he is a good boy. She is going to Delhi. We are playing. Sare subject ki tar जगह पर ही यूज हो रहे हैं, इसीलिए इनको हम सब्जेक्टिव प्रोनाउन बोल देते हैं. नाउ सम ऑफ यू मस्ट बी वंडरिंग एज टू व्हाई हैव वी टेकन इट इन सब्जेक्टिव प्रोनाउन, क्योंकि इट तो नॉर्मली सिर्फ एनिमल्स के लिए, ऑब्जेक्ट्स के लिए यूज होता है. पर्सन के लिए हमने इट क्यों लगा लिया, राइट? बट आई कम टू दैट आल्सो. नाउ आई मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी, द ऑब्जेक्टिव प्रोनाउन. सिमिलरली अ प्रोनाउन दैट इज यूज्ड इन प्लेस ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज कॉल्ड एन ऑब्जेक्टिव प्रोनाउन. और एग्जाम्पल्स हो गए हमारे हिम, हर, मी. अब इनको सेंटेंस में लगा कर देखो तो ऑब्जेक्ट की जगह ही फिट इन होंगे. आई लाइक हिम, आई एम गोइंग टू मीट हर. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एन ऑब्जेक्टिव प्रोनाउन. फिर से हमने यहाँ पे इट लगा लिया, इट हमने फिर से पर्सनल प्रोनाउन में डाल दिया. द रीजन फॉर दैट इज there are certain unisex words in English. Words like baby, child, ये ऐसे words हैं जिनका कोई gender नहीं होता है. और जिन words का कोई gender नहीं होता है उनको हम unisex words बोलते हैं. Child और baby के लिए we should never use a he, she or him, her. Please remember, we have to always use it. For example, the child lost its toy. The baby hurt its leg. अगर हम his और her लगाएंगे तो हमारा सेंटेंस गलत हो जाएगा. अनलेस द सेंटेंस स्पेसिफाइज अबाउट द जेंडर ऑफ द चाइल्ड. एक हमें सेंटेंस दिया हुआ है, द चाइल्ड लॉस्ट डैश टॉय ही वॉज प्लेइंग आउट इन द गार्डन. तो मतलब इस सेंटेंस में क्लियर हो गया ना कि हम बॉय की बात कर रहे हैं, चाइल्ड बॉय की बात कर रहे हैं. अदरवाइज वी विल यूज ओनली इट. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. सॉरी, पोजेसिव प्रोनाउन. अ पोजेसिव प्रोनाउन इज अ प्रोनाउन दैट इज यूज्ड फॉर पोजेशन. इट शोज पोजेशन, मेरा, तेरा, उसका, राइट. So my possessive pronouns are his, her or hers, my, mine, our or ours, their or theirs. So since they have to show possession, my sentence is, this is his room. I am going to their house. Unke ghar, possession dikha raha hai. Now, can we differentiate between the objective and possessive pronoun here? It is very simple. Objective pronoun can stand independently on its own. It does not need an object. क्योंकि हमारे objective pronoun की definition ही यही है कि वो object की जगह पर जो use हो रहा है उसको objective pronoun बोलते हैं. So, I like him. Him is my objective. But can I say I like his? My sentence gets incomplete. अगर मैंने कहना है I like his, उसके पीछे मुझे कोई ना कोई object लगाना पड़ेगा. I like his car, I like his shirt. So that is about the personal pronouns. Now, if you keep these personal pronouns in your mind and you know where do they have to be placed, there are very small chances that you would go wrong in their usage. See, because English is all about usage. It is not knowing about the rules of grammar, or it is not knowing about the meanings. जब तक आपको वो वर्ड सही जगह पर यूज करना नहीं आएगा तो आप गलती करेंगे. So let's move on to the next category, which is called the demonstrative pronoun. Now, as the name suggests, demonstrative means something that demonstrates, tells us about something else. It's demonstrating. So my demonstrative pronouns are this, that, these, and those, wherein this stands for something nearby. I'm sitting here on the table, so this is a table, and that refers to something that is far off. That is the door. That is the window. And these is the plural of this. Now, how do we make mistakes? And how does demonstrative pronoun help us in correcting those sentences? I have written two sentences here. Let's look at them. The population of Delhi is more than the population of Hisar. Right? Now the meaning is being conveyed. मैं जो कहना चाह रही हूँ वो कहा जा रहा है. आप समझ भी रहे हैं मैं जो कह रही हूँ कि दिल्ली की population हिसार की population से ज्यादा है. But the structure of the sentence is wrong. And I come across students who end up, you know, writing the sentence in this format. या फिर उनको कहो कि क्यों गलत है ये, population दो बार लगा दी आपने. How can there be repetition of noun in one sentence? And what is the purpose of pronoun? We take a small example here. I say Ram is a good boy. Ram has two brothers. Ram goes to college every day. तो लगता है ना सुनने में गलत है और हमें पता भी है गलत है. So to correct it, what will we do? Ram is a good boy. He has two brothers. He goes to college every day. Ram की जगह हमने pronoun fit कर दिया he. Similarly, यहाँ पर पॉपुलेशन दो बार आ रहा है तो हमें पॉपुलेशन की जगह एक प्रोनाउन फिट करना पड़ेगा. एंड इवन द सेकंड वे ऑफ राइटिंग द सेंटेंस इज रॉन्ग. लेट्स जस्ट लुक एट दैट. द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ दिल्ली इज मोर देन हिसार. व्हाट आई हैव टू डू इज आई हैव टू कंपेयर द पॉपुलेशन, नॉट पॉपुलेशन विद द सिटी. इस सेंटेंस में तो एक जगह हम दिल्ली की पॉपुलेशन की बात कर रहे हैं, दूसरी जगह हम हिसार की बात कर रहे हैं, राइट. So the correct way of writing this sentence is, the population of Delhi is more than that of Hisar. So this is the usage of demonstrative pronoun. Another thing that I would like you to know here is, जब मेरा subject singular होता है, जैसे यहाँ पर population singular है, तो हमने that of Hisar कर दिया. अगर मेरा subject plural हो जाएगा, तो हम demonstrative pronoun those का use करेंगे. I'll give you an example quickly. The temples in South India are more in number than those of in North India. मैंने ये नहीं कहा the temples of South India are more in number than the temples of North India. No, I said than those of in North India. So this is all about demonstrative pronouns, and you will see that if you follow these little things, it will get so easy for you. Next is my reflexive pronouns. Now, what do we understand by reflexive pronoun? A pronoun that reflects. Reflects on what? When the action done by the subject turns back and reflects on the subject, then it is called a reflexive pronoun. So what could be the examples of reflexive pronoun? Myself, himself, herself, themselves, ourselves. These are the examples of reflexive pronouns. Now one thing is very clear from the definition here, कि अगर आगे मेरा subject नहीं है, तो हम पीछे reflexive pronoun का use नहीं कर सकते. That will be wrong English. So these are simple examples that I have written here. He hurt himself. Himself is reflecting upon the subject he. I will do it myself. I will do it. I say I will do it. My sentence is complete in itself. But then to emphasize that I am going to do it myself. So in this case, this myself will be called emphatic pronoun also. Please don't get confused between the reflexive and the emphatic pronoun. Inke usage mein farak hota hai, right? I will do it myself. I myself will do it. I myself will do it. So when I say I will do it myself, mera myself reflexive ho jata hai. And when I say I myself will do it, mera myself emphatic ho jata hai. Let's move on to the next category, the indefinite pronouns. Now as the name suggests, anything that is not definite is called the indefinite pronoun. Let's look at the definition. When the pronoun refers to a person or a thing in general and does not refer to any person or thing in particular, we call it an indefinite pronoun. So the examples of my indefinite pronoun are one, someone, anyone, everyone, each, etc. There are two mistakes that we make. There are other mistakes also, but in particular, two things that we need to take great care of. One of them is that whenever we begin our sentence with indefinite pronoun one, we have to make sure that it does not take any other pronoun. Agar mera sentence इनडेफिनेट प्रोनाउन वन से शुरू हो रहा है, तो उस सेंटेंस में बाद में और कोई प्रोनाउन नहीं लग सकती है. लुक एट द सेंटेंस दैट आई हैव रिटन हियर. वन शुड लव हिज कंट्री. एंड अ नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स यू नो आई कम अक्रॉस पीपल यूजिंग द सेंटेंस इन दिस वे. बट हम फिर से इस चीज का ध्यान रखेंगे कि अगर मेरा सेंटेंस वन से शुरू हो रहा है, तो पीछे हिज या हर नहीं लगना, पीछे सिर्फ वंस लगेगा. मेरा इनडेफिनेट प्रोनाउन वंस, राइट? वन शुड रिस्पेक्ट हिज एल्डर्स, रॉन्ग. वन शुड टेक केयर ऑफ हिज एल्डर्स, रॉन्ग. वन शुड टेक केयर ऑफ वंस एल्डर्स. वन शुड लव वंस कंट्री, राइट? दैट इज वन मिस्टेक दैट वी मेक रिगार्डिंग द इनडेफिनेट प्रोनाउन. एंड द सेकंड वन इज व्हेन अ सेंटेंस बिगिंस विद ईच, प्लीज रिमेंबर it should take always a singular subject and a singular pronoun. Here again we go majorly wrong. I'll give you an example here. Each of the boys are going to Delhi. This is how I have come across a lot of times, you know, students and the other people say the sentence in this form. Please concentrate again. मेरा सेंटेंस तो ईच से शुरू हो रहा है और मेरा सेंटेंस था ईच ऑफ द बॉयज आर. द मोमेंट वी सी बॉयज देयर हमें लगता है बॉयज के बाद आर आना चाहिए. बट व्हाट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर इज माय मेन सब्जेक्ट इज ईच एंड देयरफॉर माय राइट सेंटेंस विल बी ईच ऑफ द बॉयज इज गोइंग टू डेली. मे बी सम ऑफ यू यू नो गेट द फीलिंग ये सुनने में गलत लग रहा है बट दैट इज व्हाट वी हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ. सिंगुलर pronoun, singular subject, singular pronoun, singular verb. That is how it will move. I'm coming to relative pronoun, which is very, very important for sentence correction. Now again, we can find out the definition from the name itself. Relative pronoun refers to some pronoun or relates to some noun used before. So what will be my relative pronouns? Who, which, whom, that, those. एक चीज का आप लोग यहाँ पर ध्यान रखेंगे, हम नॉर्मली इंटरोगेटिव एंड रिलेटिव प्रोनाउंस को कंफ्यूज कर जाते हैं. हमें लगता है कि ये डब्ल्यू एच वर्ड्स हैं, who, which, whom, whose, तो सारे डब्ल्यू एच वर्ड्स हमारे रिलेटिव प्रोनाउंस हो जाएंगे. नो, वॉट इज एन इंटरोगेटिव प्रोनाउन, why is an interrogative pronoun. All the words starting with wh, how, who, which, whom, ye sare interrogative pronouns hain. Who, which, whom and whose interrogative pronouns bhi hain aur relative pronouns bhi hain. Again, it depends upon how we are using it. Like a while back I told you that that is a demonstrative pronoun, and now here I tell you that that is a relative pronoun. तो फिर से हमें देखना पड़ेगा हम इसको use कैसे कर रहे हैं. That को हमने relative pronoun की तरह use किया है या हमने demonstrative pronoun की तरह use किया है, या who, which, whom को हमने interrogative pronoun की तरह use किया है या relative pronoun की तरह use किया है. I'll explain a little more on the relative pronouns here. Normally who is used for the living, right, and which is used for the non-living. Now that we all know, but where we make a mistake is where we get confused about how should we use that, because that is used both for living and for non-living. Is cheez pe aap thoda zyada concentrate karenge. Fir se repeat kar rahi hu main, वो मेरा लिविंग के लिए यूज होता है, विच मेरा नॉन लिविंग के लिए यूज होता है. पर अगर मैं दैट के बारे में बोलूं तो दैट मेरा दोनों के लिए यूज होता है, फॉर लिविंग एंड नॉन लिविंग. देन हाउ डू आई डिफरेंशिएट? प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट समथिंग जनरल, इन जनरल, तो मैं हु और विच का यूज करूंगी. एंड व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट something particular, then I am going to use who for the living and which for the non-living. That is all as far as I had to talk about type of pronouns. But another thing that I would want you to know is, it is not that there are only these type of five type of pronouns that I have shared with you, or the slides that I have shared with you. Beech mein maine aapko interrogative pronoun ki bhi baat kar li. But these are the pronouns that are more important than the other pronouns for sentence correction. And we as foreign users of the language, हमें interrogative pronoun में दिक्कत नहीं आती है, but हमें relative में ज़्यादा आ जाती है. Interrogative हमें clear है कि जहाँ हमने question पूछना है, वहाँ पे हम interrogative pronoun लगा देंगे. So that is all from my side as far as pronouns are concerned. Thank you very much.